Hello boys and girls, and welcome back to the wonderful world of trucks and trains and ships and planes, or in our case of horse carriages and steam engines. And yeah, I am MackTheKnife and we are playing Transport Fever. For every one of you who didn't watch my long 6.5 hour stream introducing the game and covering the first 30 years, you can find a link of it right here. Or let me just recap quickly what I have done. The first thing we did, or I did, is connecting Naperville to Salt Lake City with a passenger route, and later on extending this route over here to Pueblo. And you can see all three cities are developing quite a bit, and our train stations are full, and the goal for this episode is to modernize our passenger service. Later on I established our first production chain from this farm here near Yonkers. I built a small train station here and a short truck or carriage route to bring down grain and livestock to the train station, and we transport all the goods. And there we have autosave. We transport all the goods to this food processing plant near Salt Lake City. Of course, I could have used this processing plant near to Naperville, but I choose that one because from here we can extend the production chain over to Pueblo, back to Naperville, and over here to Riverside. Yeah, that was all what happened in the stream. Most of the time we spent just waiting for money and fixing small mistakes. And I still have, I would not call it a mistake, but there is this train, but it's not really optimal. Reason for that is this farm over here is a little bit undecided about what they want to produce. At the moment they produce the same amount of grain and livestock, but over the course of the game that changed many times. Sometimes grain was a lot, also grain production was a lot higher than livestock production, and I built this train accordingly, having less livestock carts than grain carts. And now the farm decided, oh, let's produce all in the same amount. And yeah, basically this train has always two empty carts now, what just cost me money, and anytime I have to optimize that. We also modernized this production chain here already. We have the American horse cart now, what has a high speed of 20 kilometers an hour and transports 5 units of products. And it seems, let me check this. Oh, they're good in stock. It seems that the amount of carts what I have on this route is not enough. So the first thing I will do is add more carts here. We have money rolling in. There we go. 920,000, that is wonderful. So let's just buy some more American horse carts. Let's say three should be fine. And this is Salt Lake City food delivery. So go and do your job. We also have quite some debts to pay back. I still have a loan of seven and a half million. And I want to modernize this passenger line because the trains here are quite a few years over the lifespan. As you can see, they are not really pretty anymore. There is rust everywhere. So that's the first thing I want to do in this episode. Problem is, one new train costs $3.5 million. The prices went a good bit up in the last 30 years. So we have to repay our debts and then, repay our debts so we can afford a new passenger train. And I think I will replace one first and then go for the second one. And it might be even time. Let me check this. Okay, let's borrow some money and let's see if this train will be replaced. Yes, wonderful, a new shiny train. Look at this, isn't that beautiful? That is worth a screenshot in my book. This train should drive now with 60 kilometers an hour and, oh come on, 60 kilometers an hour instead of 45. So he delivers the passenger, or transports the passengers a good bit faster than before, and that should give us more profits. Hopefully, because this train is quite expensive. How fast is he now? 41. Now come on, pick up some speed. Okay, now we are faster than the previous train already. And let's just follow this train and let's see how much money we really make. And I'm still not used to the controls. Middle mouse button is turning the camera. Yeah, this is really quite a bit faster. Speeding towards Pueblo with a full train load. I guess that will give us somewhere between 200 and 250,000. How far we are? There's Pueblo. Okay. And I still didn't find a solution for the frame rate problem. The frame rate is crawling anywhere between 20 and 25 frames per second. It's okay for this kind of game, but it's not really optimal. And it's definitely not a graphics problem, because my graphics card is definitely strong enough, and no matter which graphic options I turn on or off, the frame rate doesn't really get much higher. So I think it's something about the computation of the simulation here what slows the whole game down. So let's see. Payday. 333,000. I'm quite happy with that. And how many passengers will we take? A full load. Wonderful. How many are left here? 8. Okay. I'm quite happy with this. And this train will be much faster than the other one. Where's the other one? The other one left behind 65 people. Okay, then we just need to get $3.5 million more to replace the second train. Then we are fine. As you can see, we still don't have a lot of money. It's quite a fight to get money in this game. So in this episode, it will be shorter than the live stream. I promise it will be much shorter, but there will be times where I just can wait, because I don't really want to speed up the time. I want to play in real time. And I also don't want to cut out anything. So there will be times where nothing much is happening and I'm just waiting for money to come in. But I will put a small marker, annotation, whatever, down here to enable you to jump to the next section, where actually something happens, so you don't have to wait with me. If you wanna follow the whole gameplay, that is super. If not, I can completely understand it, and just use the marker down here and jump to the next section. And while we are waiting, I promise, anytime I will get it managed with English. But while we are waiting for money to come in, let's do a little bit housekeeping. First of all, give this video a like down below. That will really help me out and will spread the video further. Makes me more famous and rich, and first of all enables me to do more videos without worrying how I will survive the next month. No, it just will enable me to do more videos because I can spend more time on YouTube. It's not that I'm starving. Everything like this. The other thing is, of course, subscribe to my channel if you're not already, so you don't miss any other episodes. And share this video around. As more people can see it, the better, the more happy I get. And you want me to be happy, right? So let's see, next payday. Why is full train load up to Pueblo 333 and full train load down from Pueblo 100,000 less? That is weird. And our train station is basically empty. Nice. Yeah, now we have a faster train and this train needs to wait for it. Okay. They pass on a good spot, so the other train don't need to slow down too long. Or too much. Perfect. So how much does this one give us? $190. This old train gives us almost as much as the shiny new one. That's not nice. Come on, I hope you will be worth your money. So let's just pay back some of our loan so that our interest payments are not so high. Yeah, but this train is definitely a good bit faster. I hope that Urban Games, the developer of Transport Fever, will bring out a patch soon to get these performance problems under control. I mean, at the moment the game plays nicely. It's okay, it's everything moves, it's kind of smooth, it's fine. But I worry a bit about the later state when we have a lot more train lines and maybe planes coming in and ships and all the stuff and the city's growing bigger, and I worry the frame rate will drop to 10 or less. That wouldn't be nice anymore. Next payday is within reach. Let's see what we get. It should be definitely another full train. Yeah. And Napa will grow quite substantially. So when we will bring the first goods in here, I think this town will explode. 350,000, that is very fine. Running costs went definitely down, or maybe not, it's just half the year, so Yeah, the running costs will be much higher, but this train made the whole trip from Pueblo to Naperville in half a year, when before it took them almost 1 year to do the whole trip. Talking and me is... doesn't work out of today again. So let's just see. Oh, all our lines are profitable. Some more, some less, but they all are. That's very nice. How does our food production looks? Very fine. We still have livestock in the processing plant, and the next delivery is on its way. And we almost have a 500,000 together again, which we will repay directly. Road Vehicle 6. What is Road Vehicle 6? Yoga's footage. Yeah, I want to replace them with American horse cards. That is a good point. How does Salt Lake City look at the moment? We deliver 77 of 88 food units. So we need to expand our production chain for food very soon, so it will not stall to an halt. And ching, 979. Okay, we repay 1 million. How does it look here? Okay, production is safe for another half year. And here it goes up quite a bit. And I really need to replace those carbs. Yonkers food exchange. American horse carbs. Okay. Replace automatically. There we go. And of course now I don't have the money to replace them, or do I? No, I don't. But there should be a passenger train on its way to Salt Lake City. Oh, this train has to... that's not good. That is not good. This train now has to wait for this one. That will push our prices down, so I should put a drive-by lane here. Let me do this directly. No, I cannot do it now. Come on. But I should do it very quick, very soon. I I didn't thought that through. I think we will lose at least 100,000 on that trip. But it's fine. It'll just take all a bit longer. Then our road vehicles here should be replaced now. Why is really? Okay, as soon as the second passenger train arrives in Salt Lake City, then our road vehicles should be replaced. Oh look, one already got replaced. Second passenger train, please. Soon. Okay, the passenger train will not bring in enough to cover 340,000, definitely not. 288. So it will take us a bit to replace all of that vehicles. Let's see what our food train does. How much is waiting? A lot of livestock now and very few grain. Disappointing, very disappointing. But let's see how much the horse carts will make, the American horse carts. $300 more. That's fine. Okay, let's just borrow quickly some money back so our horse carts can be replaced now and not in 2 or 3 years, to speed up this whole food chain a bit. Come on, you can do it. There we go. One last. There we go. All the carts got replaced and the line still is in the green, so everything is fine. Now it should speed up the whole transportation a good bit and hopefully our train will be filled on the next round. And then we have the next problem, because we will need a second train. Okay, production here is going up, going down. Tell me something. Yeah, you see that? They produce much more grain than they do livestock. Potentially, it changes by season. I think we have now April. Makes sense. They produce more grain when it's harvesting time. Okay, I see how that works. But we still need to get all the stuff delivered. Here comes the next big payday. Most likely not that big right now. $870,000. Good enough to pay back some of our loan. So now I need to urgently put in a takeover lane here. I don't want to go with two lanes for the whole length of the track right now. I think it's a bit early for that. We have more important things we have to do. But that should stop our faster train. Seriously, I don't have $3,000. Nice. But money should come in a moment. Let's follow that train, shall we? It looks really pretty. And I made a mistake here because I was thinking about he will stand here and will come around here then. So this curve allows just for 50 kilometers an hour. So he loses a bit of speed before he gets into the train station, but I think it's okay for now. Where's the second train? Down there. That's not good, so this train have to wait here a lot. I think I have to go double track very soon. Okay, now let's put our second signal in place before the money is gone again. Right here. There we go. So how much do you carry? 59 people. Could be better. Could be a lot better, but okay. Quite some traffic at the train crossing, but it's okay, we have enough cops waiting over here. But production slows down. Why does production slow down? That's not good. Oh, it looks here. Production still goes up. That's fine. How much is waiting? Oh, our train is almost full. Oh, it basically is full. That's wonderful. So upgrading the horse carts was definitely a good idea. Okay, they take everything. At any point in time, I might put two separate lines here, one for grain and one for livestock, just to have a little bit more control over what really gets delivered. And we are in the red numbers again. Why are we in the red numbers? We make a profit. Why I don't see this profit on my bank account? Is anything on auto replace? No, it's not. That's weird, isn't it? We will see. Our train arrives here. How many people are waiting? 107. This route is really exploding. 300,000. 300,000 and we are still not in the green. Our bank account is still negative. That's encouraging. How can I be 3 years in a row in the green and still have a negative bank account. Wonders of the world. But here comes our next million rolling in. It should be more than a million now. $1.1 million. Beautiful. We can repay 500,000. At least. So, Salt Lake City, how is your situation? We deliver 75 of 91 fruit units. So, we are still fine. No, we are not fine because the production is 112. We deliver 75. Where's the difference? You store 60 units. Why do you store 60 units? Mysterious. But we are almost there. I think one more round from the food train, and we can modernize the second passenger train. Oh, we definitely need another food train. Definitely. That is a full train right there. A full train right there, and this train just came out of the station. So a second train basically could be on its way to Salt Lake City right now. That would be an extra million. Definitely something to consider. This farm soon will upgrade again, I think. So we need to keep an eye on this. I also need to expand our food delivery up here. The question is, do I let this train deliver goods or food to Pueblo, or I will use a dedicated train for the food delivery. And he can make one trip up to Pueblo, comes back here, and then makes a trip down to Naperville. And he only leaves the station if he is full. Or it, not he. It only leaves the station if it is full. How much is waiting? Second train definitely makes sense. And look, we almost made a million in profit last year. That's just beautiful. Oh no, that is this year. We made a million in profit this year, and it is just June. it keeps going like this, I'm quite happy with our situation right now. Of course, there's always space to improve. There's a lot what we leave behind. So that would be our next goal. Setting up a second food train and expanding the route up to Pueblo. And can you believe that we are already 45 minutes into the video? I thought I can get something done. It seems not really. I still need to wait. But not for long. Our passenger line will be upgraded in a second. Where is the second? Why is he down there? For Christ's sake. That's the slow train. Why is this one down? No, wait, where is he? Oh, he's up here. Okay, my bad. He's on his way to Pueblo. And there's a full train waiting. Okay, my bad, everything is fine. No reason for panic. There's also a full train waiting. And here, okay, the station just got the train out of there. But just look at it, how many people are walking towards the station. I almost could put on another couple of horse carriages, horse carts, to work on our commuter line. At least the line what runs counterclockwise. That would almost make sense. But not now. Concentrate. We have to modernize a passenger train. Where's our food train? Food train is there. Could be enough. We need 3.2 million. When I borrow 2.5 million plus this delivery, what is 1.1 million makes 3.6 million. That should be enough to modernize this passenger train. And then everything should run smoothly again. Looking here, 112 production. Come on, we can do that. There we go, 1.2 million in the back, and hopefully this train will arrive here before December. Let me just turn off this, I don't want to see how much money we lose every time. That just slows down our game. But look, we made 2 million profit this year. That's wonderful. Come on, train. Be here before the year is over, otherwise it costs a lot of money again. Money we don't have. Will he make it? Maybe not. On, you can do it. You can do it. 7 days left. No, he will not make it. Not in December anymore. Will the money be enough? That gets close. But let's try. Let's try. Oh, that could be enough. And he didn't get replaced. Why he didn't get replaced? Will you be replaced? Why not? Auto replacement is on. Why he didn't get replaced? Didn't he reach his lifetime? But we have another engine, and let's see. It can run 75. I think that will be the engine for our food train. Because the passenger trains are actually fast enough for a while, but our food train definitely can use some speed up. So now this train arrives here and he needs to wait here for this train. That will be about a half year of waiting. That's not good. But okay, it will be the last time. I hope the money will be more than 3.2 million when this train arrives in this train station, so we can finally modernize it. Let me set this down. Because apparently he didn't reach his full lifespan. That's why he wasn't replaced in Naperville, but he should be at least above 25% of his lifespan, its lifespan. So that should work. Then we need to figure out how much will the new food train cost us. Sorry. Oh, we lose valuable dollars here. goes down. Not good. Come on, you can do it. There we go. Will it be replaced? That's the question. Look at our money. Please replace the train. Yeah, okay. Wonderful. So we can turn the auto replacement off here. And this one is full. 20 people waiting at the station. So these two trains will make us quite some money in the next years. Because they are faster and have a higher capacity. Look at this, 84 people are waiting here already again. And down here it will be even more, right? No, that's not what I wanted. 110. So the train will be always full. How is it looking here? The train just left, right? Where is it? Oh, it's down here. So there comes our next million in, hopefully. He is full, he is completely full. That will be another million. And we need to get our production up. So the first thing we do is extend the food production chain to Pueblo and deliver food to Pueblo. But this will be something for the next episode. We are 1 hour into the video now. I think this is long enough for one episode. I'm sorry that not much happened. As I said, I always have to wait for the money, as you have seen. But we modernized our passenger service, and in the next episode, we take on our food production. Until then, give this video a like down below, leave me some comments, tell me what I might do better besides trying to speak English, and tell me what you don't like, what I should do next, whatever comes to mind. If you say I shouldn't play this game at all because I'm not any good, you can tell me, but it will not change anything. Also, subscribe to my channel that you don't miss out on the next episodes, what will come out very, very soon. I think I will record another episode directly after this one, and maybe I will upload it after this one too, directly after this one too. Yeah, I hope I will see you all in the next video. Until then, have a good one.